Hey guys, it is the 17th of December. We are very much closing in to Christmas Day. And it's also my dad's birthday. Have to go there tonight. Now we have a ABUS 6540, 40 millimeter, of course, short shackle. I actually don't know if you can get these with longer shackles, but I do know you can get the 8540s with long shackles. We have the keyway and the bitting. A little bit flat, but it does have some high-low. Let's see if we can get this thing open. Hopefully we can. ABUSes are always a fun pick. And some focus, and let's take the smallest pick we have, and a... Shall we go top or bottom up the keyway on this one? Let's just see if this one fits. It does not. Okay. What about this one? That will. But I think I will do bottom of the keyway. That's what I'm mostly used to. No. That doesn't work. Okay, let's just, I don't want to use too much time finding a tensioner, so let's just jump right into it. If we can. Oh, that felt like an overset. Maybe I should go with a short hook. Just got a slight turn on 5, and now we're in a false set. And I have to be very careful what I do now. And I have to make sure that I take the right pin. Yes. Pin 2 is set. And we have pin 4. Come on, now, fell off, keep falling off. I don't think I got it, no. Can get under it and get a nice grip on it, so let's try the thin one here, see if we can possibly get just under it. Well, I did get under it, there we have it. I get clear feedback, but at the same time I can get it set. Where's my other short hook? Maybe I don't need the short hook, maybe this thing. Let's try. The worst that can happen is that I don't get the pin set. Is it broken or is it just bent? Okay, I just bent this very much. Okay, we go with the short hook then. Okay, that is confusing. Now it's 2 pins that gives feedback. I haven't been this far in this lock before. I think I have been giving this luck 2 tries, unsuccessful, on camera, but didn't upload the videos because this is for the Christmas series and I have to open them. That's how I do it. I keep falling into the bottom of the keyway. So let's change to a bottom of the keyway tensioner. And I feel the pins better personally with a bottom of the keyway. Okay, now that's confusing. Pin 3 and pin 4. What about 5? Not so much on 5, but 3 and 4. Okay, now I just want to look here. I have pin 2, that's a high cut. The pin both 3 and 4 is relatively low. 4 is the lowest. Does that have the longest pin? But do I trust 3 or do I trust 4? Both give me the feedback. I have to take a choice. I take pin 3. That didn't do anything. They will not get all the way back. So I have to do it manually, which I hate doing. It felt like I was almost having the pin set. So let's do what I sometimes do on Rukos. We get the pin and I do clockwise tension on the bottom of the keyway and counter rotate with the top of the keyway. There we go. And I lost the false set. So I think I took the wrong pin. Should have gone with 4. Dang it. Now I've got a slight turn. Come on. That was all it needed. Okay. I didn't even touch the pins that much. But, yeah, okay. I'm gonna take it. by the way, I don't know if anyone else do that, but when I work on Rukos with gin bottles and undercuts in the core, well, because of the sleeve, that's a trick I use, is when I have to manually counter rotate. It's hard to do only with the bottom of the keyway or only at top of the keyway, but when I have the pick in there, I can do the clockwise tension on the bottom of the keyway and manually counter rotate with the top of the keyway and still maintain the tension. That way I do not reset all the pins, but that can happen, of course. That way I don't have as big of a risk of resetting all of the other pins. And it works on spools too, if you get to this problem where you have two pins that gives you feedback. Not that I use that much on spools, but you can use it. There you go. I'm actually a little bit interested in seeing if I can sip or rock or rake this open, so let's just give a quick go on that. I'm not gonna do too much, but just a quick go. Where is the half diamond? I have to remember to stretch that out again and put those back into their places. Where's the half diamond and the other things? Rake, other rake, and there we go, half diamond. Okay, let's sip it. Oh, try to. Slide turn. Nope. Rocking. Yeah, false set. Small false set, though. And from there, it's just stuck. And I guess the same will happen with this. Yeah. Just stuck. So you cannot rake and rock and sip this one open. Maybe sipping is the easiest one because you can have a different tension. At least I can. Anyway, let's get this on the tree and then we are done for today. That was much easier than yesterday. Okay, tree, focus. And we put it over there. So, as always, the beautiful star on the tree for this year. Good old Rukal. First luck this year we picked American Lockwood. Then we have the rest randomly. Euro Locks, 40mm. IFM, 45mm. Morris, 1100 clone. IFM, 50mm. Unknown padlock from West Germany. Yale, Y110/35 and 30 and 30. Abis, 85/40. 25mm. TSA lock, 30mm QQQ, which is a triple Q, which is a copy of the tricircle locks. Castle 440, 30mm Bastion, 30mm Flying Tiger Krabby lock, 40mm WB short shackle cool lock, and now the Abis 6540. Okay, a couple of not so cool locks and a lot of cool locks is on the tree now. And only 7 days to go. 1 week from now, it's Christmas Eve. Thanks for watching. Remember, skill always beats luck, and have a great Christmas.